The sun is just now going behind the house to the west of us, so I can come out and sit. It's a weird time when the house is still hotter. Outside, the temperature's dropped down into the 90s. And now the sun is setting. I won't get burned just by letting it shine on me. This is the third hot day we've had, and there's at least four or five more. It's definitely a case of the day the earth caught fire. I'm out here with my big glass of ice, and unfortunately the ants are out here too. They're harvester ants, scrounging around, looking for tidbits like you on the ground. As long as they don't bite, I don't mind. But sometimes they bite. Gonna have the real thing, as they say. I used to, actually, a bunch of us in the family, my aunt and uncle, my cousin, sometimes her older brother, but he was 16 years older than me, so. And then my brother and me. My parents and aunt and uncle and one cousin or two cousins and my brother and me, we'd all go to my grandmother's house and watch TV in the late 50s. And early 60s. She had one of the first TVs in the family. It was a little old thing with a little old tube, and of course only black and white. We watched that, I remember, through the 1950s we watched that. And then she got a color TV. She was one of the first one in the family to get a color TV. She had really good reception. In those days you had to have an antenna, you know. It was even before cable. So anyhow, we'd sit and watch TV, and my grandmother would offer us Cokes. Coca-Cola. Yeah. Those were the days.
There's an interesting effect over there. Sunlight rays, rays of sunlight shining through the edges of the cloud. You see it? See the spreading of the rays there? And the bright part where the sun has just set. Yes.
Sitting out here, enjoying the book. I've been reading a little bit of it every day, of just a few words. It's starting to catch on me, though. I'm wondering Perhaps I could write. Oh, I lost my place. Don't want to do that. Perhaps I could write. This is dedicated to my father. Let's see if I can see this right. There it is. Yeah. It's an interesting little story about a writer who went on a trip with her family back in the, I think it was in the 30s, 1930s. Traveling around, might have been in the 40s, so I should look at the date, but I just closed the book. Following the Oregon Trail from Missouri out across the continent to the west. Yeah. So wonderful. Now that the heat has faded away. Oh man. It is a few days before summer, but it feels like it's been summer forever. Oh, ice cube. Today is Thursday. Now it's getting to be night because the sun has set. I showed you the moon up there, with a line almost perfectly straight across the middle of it. The first quarter, it's growing, it's waxing. It was new on Thursday a week ago when there solar eclipse took place by the North Pole. It was an annular eclipse, not a total. So today is the eighth day of the moon. It's also the 90th day of spring. Just a few more days and it'll be astronomically, officially, summer. I don't think I'll be here much longer. I came in August thinking I'd only stay a few months, but that was 9 months ago. It it's just about time for me to move on. Gonna go to San Diego for a while, and hopefully the house will close and we'll sell it, and then I'll be able to head back to New York. But I'm also having a doctor's appointment on the 12th of July. So we'll see what she says about my driving through high altitudes. I may have to take the southern route through Arizona and New Mexico to avoid the high altitudes of Colorado because of my lungs, you know. She may even tell me not to go at all, which is a bit of a worry, but I'll take that one as it comes.
I'm sitting here noticing how, as the light fades away, the puffy little clouds start taking on sort of charcoal gray shapes against the deeper blue of the sky as it turns towards black down below. There's still a trace of gold and orange from the sunset. And Venus is right there somewhere. I can see it with my eye, but I can't see it in the viewfinder. But I know it's right above that little patch there of cloud. Right there. See if we can focus on the little cloud. Yes. There it is, right up there. Huh? That's it. That's Venus. The evening star. And it's right above that pokey little cloud there. Yeah. The cloud's moving. It used to be right below it, but now it's moving off to the side of ways. And these puffy little bits of cloud have an interesting color of gray and blue-gray and rising up towards another shape of whiteness, another kind of whiteness. The cloud and the moon. Making its own little kind of movement. Its own breath of haze. Yes. You can almost see the rounded curve of the dark side now. It's getting that dark. It's getting that dark. You can see the notches in the shadow where mountains and valleys. Oh, look, there goes a piece of cloud right in front of it. You can see the like little dark teeth on the moon. Those are lowlands where the light doesn't shine in, whereas just north and south of it, like lips, are the highlands reaching around the dark shadows. Yes. That's how much twilight there still is. Quite a lot. Quite a lot of twilight. Yeah. Thursday evening. After sunset. 17th of June. Just a few more days. And astronomically it will be summer.